again Danai, and this is me. We are in our kitchen, and this is a sunset. And these flowers were picked by our fellow colleague Smile, who is not here today. This is a picture from an exhibition that happened in Kassel some weeks ago. You can play. Here we're setting it up. It happened at KMMN in the Hauptbahnhof. And here's me and Danai looking at my exhibited artwork in that exhibition. For the privileged. It's not mine, it's someone else's. This is video. Yeah, this is the event with the exhibition. It's over now, unfortunately. Ah, look. Here we have a traditional Greek plate. It is very tasty. It's called Gimusta, which means stuff. So, it's comprised by stuffed vegetables like tomatoes that you fill with rice and raisins and spices. And it goes together with potatoes and stuffed peppers, and it's very tasty. Me and Danai made it last week. Here is a very professional photo that I think it is very professional. At Mutabar here in Kassel. Here's Danai, as you can see, she's my primary model. Here's my team, the artist of this piece. And here is a friend, Angie, who did an intervention in our performance. And this is me, all lonely because the bar was closing and nobody wanted to take a photo with me. The photo is by Danai, so credit to her. Here's a video from a friend of mine that's traveled all around the world. Maybe you can see a small part of it. This is from Berlin. Me and Danai, for our break from this performance, we went to Berlin for 5 days, and we went to see a theatrical play. It was Macbeth, and it was an open-air theater. It was very cold. Here's me, and this is the girl who hosted Danai in Berlin, and this is her friend. And this is me and Danai in the lake here in Buga, paddling, when it was actually warm. This is kind of how it is today in Kassel. This is the view from our window in our house.
That we will ask you to stay for the whole hour of the concert. which is until 7 o'clock, because it is very important for us in order to build a situation in this room. But if you want to live in the middle of the concert, you can, of course, by using that door, and give me some feedback before you go, to us and to the whole group. So you will have to speak aloud if you want to go in the middle, and give some feedback about the experience and where you're living. And two more things is that we have to speak one by one because of the acoustics of the room, which are a little bit special. And we have to be also careful with the curtains because they are a little bit fragile.
Does anybody else want to share his Facebook?
No, but maybe some questions before. Does anybody have some questions to Eleni about her Facebook account or something
see,
that you see?
I cannot see any advertising.
Really? Does it normally show?
Yes. In the wall, it shows.
This is your profile.
So I decided to share with you my page today, and I invite you if you want to ask me questions about everything. This is a drone. I made it about 6 months ago, maybe more. And this picture was actually taken in August when it was supposed to be still summer. Yeah, there it is. It's a view from our window. Removed our bikes from the place they were, and we were searching all around the neighborhood. And then we discovered that he had hidden them in the cellar because he didn't want them to be in front of the stairs. And some other time I saw a woman, but we didn't say anything, we just smiled. And that's pretty much my interaction with my neighbors for the last 2 months.
I apologize for the man.
Okay. He left a note, but it was German and I couldn't read it, so yeah.
And how long did you stay in Kassel?
Since I was here for the opening for 3 weeks, then I went for 3 weeks again to Athens, and then I came again at the 17th of July, when Athens exhibition was over.
your picture in your profile? Where is it made?
This one?
Yes.
It is in Istanbul, in Kadıköy.
Can you
in Istanbul.
When was it?
It was last year, last May, maybe. Not this May, but one before.
Does anybody from you would like to share their Facebook account with us? Do that.
Hello, my name is Ikumi from Japan, and I'm on 2 weeks holiday now. I start Osaka, Japan, and then visit friends in Europe. I have lived in France 13 years ago, and I visit friends from recently. This photo is from airport in Korea, in Seoul, and I really love this statue of Buddha. There's many characters of Buddha.
Would you mind giving us some feedback? Sorry, so we just need to be very quiet so we can hear them. Just a second, please.
I'm very bored with Facebook, usually, and this is even more boring. I'm sorry, I don't think Facebook is that interesting.
And why is it even more boring?
Hearing about people's personal experiences. And, I mean, I'm happy for you. Go enjoy vacation time for the, yeah. I'm just not interested in watching people's accounts and not hearing them.
I have very short time at the Documenta, so I think I have an idea of what this is, and I'm going to see the other venues.
Oh, please, could you share us the idea that you have about this?
This piece?
Yeah.
I think I need some time to reflect on it. It seems kind of interesting in its own way. A little bit embarrassing too, but I think it's part of the concept. Yeah.
But interesting in what way?
In the way I just said, actually, the way that embarrassment is part of the artwork. Like social awkward situations, like what we're experiencing right now.
Okay. Would you like us to try something else that you might find interesting?
What would that be?
Well, what do you find interesting?
I mean, the Facebook is interesting from a tech perspective and commercial perspective, but not like this. I mean, I could also turn the question around. Why should I watch other people read out their Facebook accounts aloud?
We're trying to interpret the score, and we try to understand how we portray ourselves in different ways. And obviously, Facebook is a very important way in which people portray themselves. And we're trying to identify the differences between how we are in reality and how we portray ourselves in Facebook. But this is only the second time that we bring Facebook into the interpretation of this code. So it's not just Facebook that is we base the whole interpretation of this score on. And we are open to different suggestions for a possibility to interpret the score differently.
I don't know. Isn't it pretty obvious how people usually portray themselves on Facebook? I don't know.
Is it obvious for everybody how we portray ourselves in Facebook?
Well, I wouldn't say that the way we portray ourselves on Facebook isn't the way that we really are. And because, like, we don't want to show everything that we are on Facebook. Of course, we only want to show, like, one of the better things, I'd say, on a social networking site like Facebook. Because we don't want to show our bad sides, our weaknesses to strangers.
But that's not exclusive to Facebook.
Of course not. But it's one example why Facebook isn't like the way to go if you're searching for a website that actually shows people how they are. If you know what I mean.
It's up to them. If they have made feedback and obviously if they want to leave, they can leave. If they want to change the situation, they are most welcome. If we all want them to stay, maybe we can.
Do you want us to do? No, I would say so. I would just make you say my cousin.
I personally don't want you to leave. I think it's a great opportunity that you could use to experience something that you might not ever experience again.
But why is that interesting? Why is that? Well, so, experiencing something that you might never experience again. I mean, I do that every single moment of my life.
But this is, of course, like, you're never going to end up in like the exact same situation twice, but many situations in our daily lives are very similar to the ones that we lived through yesterday or the day before yesterday, for example. And of course, I understand that you might not be interested in reading other people's Facebook posts, but still, you don't know what else is going to happen. Maybe something else happens, or well, I think it's not the best idea to immediately judge this as something that's going to be extremely boring if it only just started, you know? That's why I would recommend you to stay a little bit longer, see if it really is as boring as you thought, and then, make the choice if you want to leave or not. But that's just a recommendation, so it's your choice.
I need something more.
Are you working on the artwork, or you're just a visitor like us? Okay. So who here is working on the project?
Yeah, just ask, what would you ask me that if you took this step on your own now to leave, or if you're part of the work?
What do you think?
I'm not sure.
It could be. Yeah.
Because you're still here, I think.
Maybe you are the only one who's not part of it. We're just waiting for you to go and show your Facebook, because that's basically the only thing that is actually a surprise.
It's an Adwell version of the Truman Show. Yeah.
Find this more interesting now. We are not looking at Facebook anymore. We are discussing whether we like this thing, this social dissonance thing. Is this more what you expected? If we do this more, would you want to stay?
This, I didn't expect anything actually going in. But I definitely think this is much more interesting than scrolling down a Facebook page.
But there is a message now. I cannot read.
Well, I have a question. Why should talking about Facebook be more interesting than actual Facebook? I mean, it seems one step more dissociated would be reality, which is, in this case, somehow Facebook.
Well, can I answer to this? I'd say that talking about Facebook is a lot more interesting than like actually being on Facebook, because when we talk about Facebook, we can actually have a discussion whether, for example, Facebook is... let me start the other way. If we actually talk about Facebook, we can like discuss the nature of the website instead of just looking at what people did in their summer holidays. Like, we can actually have a genuine discussion about it, you know what I mean? Instead of just looking at the Facebook posts.
I mean, if you think Facebook is just boring and nothing else, the nature of Facebook is just boredom, so why talk about the nature of boredom?
That's not what I would say. I'd say that Facebook can be boring, especially if you just look at, like, someone's holiday posts, but of course, it's also like a window into another person's life, and it can tell us a lot about what a person finds important, or what they did, what they're like. And that's not the only thing we can talk about. We can also talk about whether we should continue using Facebook, for example, I'm just naming examples, or like what the site should be responsible for and what not. For example, in the last years, there was like a kind of debate going on about whether Facebook should do something against like right-wing radical posts on Facebook and such. So that's one thing we could talk about. I'm just saying that there's more to this than just scrolling through someone's Facebook site. You know what I mean?
What else besides Facebook can be used to keep us in this room?
A lot of things.
What else did you use? You said you use Facebook 2 days. Yesterday and today.
What did we do?
The days before. Because I think that the dissonance is them trying to leave, and we are talking and engaging in a way instead of just watching, and I wonder how, what else?
2 days ago, we tried to, like each, or people were asked to say what they think should change from this world with a melody, and everybody will repeat afterwards. People got extremely frustrated, and many, many people left. Many. Yesterday, we took this frustration and we said, look, many of you will find this frustrating, and it's very likely that many of you will want to leave. I don't think we will be able to fulfill your expectations. And then everybody tried to do something in order to not generate frustration. So people started singing, started clapping, started like being very much together. So nobody left.
Do you personally prefer that? I mean, do you try to? Do you have a preference? People leaving or staying? Or is it more this in between, like that there is a discussion about whether I should or not? That is mostly.
I think it definitely is which one they found more frustrating. I think both were very frustrating, but in different ways. Mm-hmm. I was not here. I arrived today.
Start clapping.
For sharing.
But in which way was it interesting?
The way you made me feel.
How did it make you feel?
Uncomfortable, like you said. So, and I think that I've had enough uncomfortable for one day. So.
Okay, is there something that we can do to improve, you think?
Let me out.
You think it will improve if we let you out? The whole piece will improve?
Maybe, because then it could give. Maybe you could see what you feel when I have left.
Okay, so maybe we can register what people feel here now.
Well, is there anything stopping?
No.
Is
anybody else want to leave, or is it just you want to leave as well?
Okay,
without discussion.
No,
I only want to leave. Without discussion.
But
without discussion.
Yeah.
You have to respect it. So I want to be a part of your play. I don't like it.
But we asked at the very beginning.
Yeah? Okay. Without me.
Why? Please,
we
asked
for
We have asked at the very beginning.
Yeah.
You could just give us some feedback. Then we all can learn from you. Try try to do something about it, and then you can.
Okay, I stay here and we'll go together. First time.
He's managed.
Okay.
Is there something that we can do in order to make you feel the normal to be?
How many friends do you have? Sorry? Sorry? Hey, how many friends do you have?
Do you know in person, like how many?
Half or
200 or 300,
I think. In the beginning, I just put okay to everyone who asked me to be friends. And after, with message, okay. If not, ignore. So, but I've seen the friends increase. Without seeing.
Can make a queue. It seems that there is a lot of people wanting to leave.
Does nobody say anything against that?
actually don't want to discuss anything. I just want to. I don't want to discuss or something.
Sorry. Could you please everybody come here as close as possible so we can hear each other? And please be quiet so we can hear what people are saying. We just want to know and learn why do you live, so we can learn from you. We said this at the very beginning, and that's a kind of commitment. If you want to stay, you just have to fulfill these requirements. This is what this is about. You give something so we all can learn, you live. We can also try to change the situation together. Please.
Actually, I have some friends waiting outside, so that's the real, I don't know, my reason why I have to go. But I don't really like to be filmed, especially that near, in the first place. And that's why I don't really like that. And I see people that they want to leave, but you make them stay, even if they don't want that, and it makes me very sad inside and kind of emotional, and I feel very bad about that.
You do really interesting work, but that's a bit too much. So if she really wants to go,
they feel embarrassed, and nobody says anything about against that. Even if they want to leave, you don't let them leave. And
we let them leave.
Yeah, but
yes,
no,
let us leave.
She's
gone.
And she as well. Yeah, I know. I'm talking about her.
Yeah, but she don't have to. She don't want to.
So if she isn't part of the project, I'm just confused.
But you can't keep people inside.
No, I mean she can leave. She has
it confused me that nobody says anything about that situation, even if everyone sees that she feels bad about it. Why doesn't anyone speak up for her?
But you are.
I am, but I'm the only one here in the room. There are many, many people.
But I want to leave. I don't want to discuss. I didn't like the presentation. I don't like what's going on right now. So if you don't have anything against it, then I would be happy to leave.
If you give some feedback, that would be great.
I gave some feedback. I didn't like the presentation because it was boring to me. At the beginning, I thought maybe there was something to it, but it just ended in discussion, and also I don't like the way you treat people.
Also,
so,
what about the people who can't speak English? I mean,
we can,
I can try. But just the people who can't speak or understand English understand that you are saying they also could talk in German?
Yeah, of course. We've done it many times.
So,
the rules were set. It's just rules. We all talked about them. We all agree.
Maybe if she
she can leave right now.
Yeah, but I'm not talking about me.
Well, if you're talking about them, they could just say we want to leave. I don't like the presentation. Give that as minimal reasoning.
Speak
English. Oh,
then we'd be happy to translate. Why not?
Or speak in German.
Just
answer
that. Yeah, that's all right.
Deutsch ist auch okay, right?
But again, this is the group dynamics that is happening. I mean, now we have to take care of you guys because you're experiencing something that is uncomfortable, and you have a lot of people standing on your backs and saying like, "You can just leave." And so,
yeah, that's true. So let's leave. Just leave.
So.
Yeah, I just wanted
I
to say that
I understand what you're saying.
Now someone wants to get in.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
What will you do with the feedback?
We'll just try to learn. I mean, it really changes the atmosphere. Whatever has been said, as you can understand, changes radically the atmosphere.
Yeah.
It's part of what it is. It's like trying to think out loud together, trying to understand what's going on.
But this is just the art reality show. I mean, what is the difference between this and, I don't know.
But it's not their fault. If I go to a concert or to a theater, and five people in the first row, after 10 minutes, they stand up and they leave. That changes the atmosphere, but that's not the performer's fault. And we are all the performers.
Yeah. I'm really happy to be here, and I don't know you. Yeah, and maybe we can talk about what could, the rest of the time we can do something positive.
Yeah.
Not only to think about leaving. Because there are lots of people at the moment in Germany, I know refugees, yeah, they have to stay in one part of a city. They don't, it's not allowed for them to leave. Yeah, they have always this situation, like we have about 60 minutes. Come on. Yeah. They cannot leave to another country, they cannot leave to another town. Yeah, they have to stay for months, yeah, in a camp. Yeah, come on. Be happy. You want a document?
I have a little question. Can I maybe check my emails or something like that? Would that be possible? Or is that
you want to do that?
Yeah.
Does everybody agree that he checks his emails? Anybody has a problem with him checking the emails?
No problem.
Could you order pizza?
No.
Order pizza. Yeah, maybe order pizza.
Can help you.
Can we all write the emails? Can we all come together and
I'm actually waiting for an email, but
I have a question. I saw a few of you guys having been at the Parthenon of Books over there. Yeah. You picked up some books. What kind of books do you pick up and why? Can you please tell me? If you like.
What is it about? Oh, a manifesto of communism.
That one.
Wow.
Okay. This.
Can you tell us why?
Okay. There were many, many, plenty of them. And yeah, I like Spanish, so I said, okay, 24th of September is not far, so maybe I could read this again. Yeah, this one, I thought is a bit of contrary to this one, so I decided to take it. Please have a look.
Can we, thank you. Can we work in school with the Manifesto de Comunista?
If you have ideas, we can. And this was, yeah, because it's a theater thesis.
Text on it, the title, do you know what it is?
Yeah, it's a Guantanamo
Tagebuch. Also Guantanamo Tagebuch.
Okay, is it?
Yeah. And it's about a person who is arrested in Guantanamo at this moment. Mm-hmm. And this book is forbidden in the USA. Mm-hmm. And inside, I don't know, has anyone had this kind of book? Yeah, many pages are in black. So the authorities in the Guantanamo camp, it was not allowed for him to send his pages to his lecturer. Mm-hmm. Yeah. And there's another book, it's called Oil. It's about the oil problem we have, burning oil. And so.
I've got another question, but it has like nothing to do with this topic. But with you, because I was wondering, like, the whole day, why are you wearing
suits? So, like, suits, why not?
Yes?
Yeah. I mean, yesterday I had a suit too. I like suits. They look nice. I think they look nice, I'm not sure. This was to your opinion. Yeah, I like suits. It's my style. Magicians usually wear suits, and I'm a magician. So, yeah.
So, can you do any trick right now?
I guess I could. Yeah, why not? I actually have a deck of cards with me. Okay, just a second. To get ready.
You're part of the performance group in you.
I'm actually from Hamburg. But, okay.
We're still following like the true man.
Yeah. Okay, why don't I show you a trick? So all the cards actually do genuinely look different. Now I want you to pick a card. It can be anything. Just trust your instincts, okay? It can be six of hearts. It can be anything. Okay.
Just one.
Just one card, okay? So look at your card, okay? Then just give me that card. I know it's a six, but I don't know what six it is. And actually it's a five, if I'm right. Okay, I'll do something. Okay, bring your hand out. I'll put the card right on your hand. I want you to put your other hand on the card, and I want you to hold it there, okay? I have a joker here, okay? We all know why the joker is special. The joker is said to be any card when playing poker. When you play poker, you can use it as anything you want. So if I just use the joker like a credit card, it turns to the card that I need, and the card in your hand is the joker. Oh.
I thought you can disappear or something.
Can you do the one trick right now where you draw the card?
No, I'm actually sure if I can use fire in here. So.
Okay.
You can. You can. I checked before.
Actually, I can.
Why did you check?
Yeah. That's because
fire extinguishes.
Oh, it's fire extinguisher. Yeah. Well, it does need a bit of preparation. So right now. But I could do another one. If everybody's already singing.
Yeah.
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Some entertainment in there. Okay, it's a simple trick, really. You just have to follow the queen. People usually do this to win a bit of money, okay? But I do my own version. People usually do this on tables, so we do some tricky stuff, but I do it on the air, because it's just easier and it's more special. These are just normal cards. And look, for example, where's the queen right now? Just tell me, where's the queen? Yeah, right here. What I'm going to do is with three cards. So bring your hand out, please. Okay, I'm just going to put the queen right on your hand. I want this to be as fair as possible. I give you the queen. What card is in your hand? No, I lied to you. You have to learn. I always lie. Whatever happens. I'll take the queen, okay? I'll put it right in my pocket. I want this to be actually fair, okay? The queen is in my pocket. The question is, where is the queen? So where is the queen?
In your pocket.
No, it's here. You always have to follow, okay? Okay, I'm going to do this one more time, okay? Bring your hand out. I want this to be fair, okay? This time, I'll let you see this card so it's as fair as possible. Now I give you the queen. Now you do actually have the queen, right?
No.
No, you never have a queen. I always have a queen. The queen was actually back here. I always kept it there. Now I'm just going to put the nine back here, and I'm going to do this one last time. Could you bring your hand out too? And could you also bring your hand out too? Now when I want you to win, you will win. And when I want you to lose, you will lose. That's called three card Monty.
So I'm wondering, I'm not saying it's not, but I'm wondering why this is so much more entertaining than what we were doing in the beginning. I'm not saying it's not, but I would like to reflect on this. And I can sense that there's a huge difference in atmosphere since the beginning and now. So, like in the beginning, we also started with a kind of spectacle. And then the whole situation with people leaving generating a lot of frustration. And also, I could say maybe there were two groups, where the people that wanted for people to stay and others that wanted to leave, or maybe they would agree in people leaving anyway because it's their right. And I think the most decisive moment in that situation was when you said about the refugees. And I think this was, I think we all felt guilty somehow.
Sorry.
And guilt convinced everyone in an instant. I don't think anyone could, nobody said anything about how, like, our situation here is connected to refugee camps. Like, how exactly does their situation affect ours and ours then? I'm just wondering. So, yeah. No, and I felt that for a moment there was a will for people to decide altogether what we were going to do and a lot of motivation, but I think also it was lost. So we ended up with another form of entertainment because, of course, entertainment is more enjoyable than, I don't know. Yeah.
I also believe that a very big part of contemporary working experience is working in a network and trying to figure out what other people want. So it's kind of continuous work. And I see that as a negation of working when people don't want to participate in what we are having in mind and they do their own or they just want to have a good time.
Tiring, I don't know, and people wanted to leave. There were many people that didn't want to and to yeah to do what they engaged to do in the start. So I think this created a lot of division and frustration, and also I think we pushed it also a little bit too much to this direction. And yeah, and then you said this for the refugees, which, okay, I don't know, it's interesting, of course, I don't know if our situation could be really connected to theirs, but it is something to wonder if we cannot engage in one single thing for 1 hour in one situation that maybe is frustrating or uncomfortable, but it's just for an hour. This is something very interesting to think about. Yeah, and I couldn't really see what you were doing, but I think this was the first time in this whole hour that I felt people were really okay with being here. And maybe, I don't know, becoming a public is the most collective thing that we can do.
I think the way we are treated here is making us into an anonymous collective of consumers. You could organize things different, the space different, and we could actually be subjects to each other and develop things together, create things together.
Well, I think it's actually the opposite. When I came inside here, I mean, you feel like you're going to a prison. I mean, you feel almost like you're oppressed in a small room. That gives me a feeling of wanting to break out, not the feeling of wanting to be anonymous in a group. So I think this is actually the perfect situation for people to storm out. I mean, if it was dressed nicely here, nobody would just leave. Everybody would just have fun. But the goal is, of course, at least what I see, is to feel oppressed and see if you break out.
I think whether you see this as a collective of consumers or as a stage for someone to present themselves depends on what is in your head, not on the situation. We have people here who, when asked to clap, they become the audience. And we have people here who, when asked to share, they go up and share their Facebook or they share their thoughts on the refugee situation. And that reminds us that to be social, we have to share of ourselves. And I think this is why your intervention changed the atmosphere again, because then we had several instances of sharing. And of course, when we have a professional sharer, yeah, then everybody is interested because he has practiced sharing his act and his skills. Yes. But I think other people sharing was just as